see.
I
So, for me to understand, you think that we shouldn't be equal, or that there is no equality in the society that we are living?
I think we are equal.
So
it's our nature.
Ah, but you went to the no.
Wait, this side is no.
No, this side is the yes.
Do you feel that you have
So you're the only one that believes that we should pay the whole debt, right?
Why not?
I don't know.
Whether I can make a difference doesn't matter.
What?
Whether I can make a difference, so that doesn't matter. They paid it, or they took the money. Should pay it. That is what we'll all face. We become bankrupt. What ends up with us, we go to prison or whatnot, we'll be spending, or we'll be paying it off
for
years.
Can you speak up a little bit? I don't know if everybody's
okay. We will be paying it off for years if any of us goes bankrupt. They took the money for as long as it was. It was a great party that they had, but they have to pay. Whether they can or not, it doesn't really matter.
Is there anyone that would like to answer to this?
I don't believe in the big party you're talking about. I don't know if I understood right. They had a big party?
It's a figure of speech. They had good times for a few years. They had this wonderful little mix with borrowed money, everything that was left over afterwards. Crazy pensions for years, teachers and everyone getting paid ever more. Why should everyone else?
How high was it? The pensions?
Final salary pensions for the vast majority of the public sector workers, which after 40, 50 years of working for the state could be quite a lot.
How much?
60 to 80,000 euros a head.
8,000 euros?
60 to 80.
Per year?
Yes.
Wow, that's a lot.
So, good times. Those that don't have it, those that would never have it, in our generation, sucks to be us.
But you said about professions being paid so much.
Public sector workers, that includes.
Like teachers and.
Them as well.
Yeah, that's not true.
Hmm?
That's not true.
Okay.
Is there someone else who has an opinion about that? I'm sorry. Is there someone that has an opinion about that, that can validate this statement or oppose it in a way?
I guess for the majority of us it is difficult to validate or to verify any sort of information. Because be it due to lack of interest or be it due to not having the time to inform yourself or just not really not diving too deep into that subject, that we sort of, yeah, okay, fine. There's a lot of discussing going on about the subject, but in the end, you're sort of stuck there, yeah, okay, so what's right, what is wrong, do I really know this situation from different angles? Do I really know what the pension system looks like? Do I really know what the tax system looks like? Do I understand the tax system in my own country? So, from that point of view, it's difficult then to be.
Maybe it's something
would
with my.
Maybe
ears.
Better if we all came closer so that we can hear each other.
The acoustic is really hard to bear it from.
Okay.
It's nothing to do with the performance, you just can't hear clearly.
Okay. Thank
you. You the same?
Yeah. It's just a acoustic, that's fine. Thank you.
Right opinion about that. I just know that I can't know.
But you said that the statement wasn't true.
Yes.
You said yours. This is not true. Why you said it wasn't true?
Because
you can explain it.
about the money.
Yeah.
You mentioned that it was an average pension to get paid like 80,000 euros per month.
No, it was
per 80,000 euros.
Because professors in Greece get a monthly salary, like I say, an annual salary of about 20 to 30,000, so the pension is a bit less.
But that's also, I mean, we can fix on that point now, but it doesn't make really sense, because what it's just heard always, but that there are lots of, that there were lots of people in Greece who got pensions for work they, or got salary for work they didn't do anymore for years. And it's kind of a big apparat, yeah, like a big bureaucracy, and so maybe something of that is right, but not the amount and not the special situation. But also, if that is so, how can I, living in Germany, being Austrian, say they should or they shouldn't? I don't have the right.
So everyone that thinks that this matter influences them or interests them can go to that side, and people that think that this is something that they should not be concerned of can come to this side.
Go on this side of the room, and people who think it should be overthrown should go on this side of the room.
What do you mean about overthrown?
Changed.
Mm-hmm. And so any kind of like
trailer
could be like any kind of sense change?
Yes.
Side is continue in a state as is or similar as is, and over here is fundamental change.
Yes.
Thank you.
So you all believe that it should change? Should
it will. We should.
Do you think that the very format of this exhibition and this being documenta makes you or manipulates you in a way that you have to declare a more radical and show a more radical decision and play in a more, like, do you think you're conditioned by the very situation, like the camera and the documenta, and is it all this your real opinion, or is like that you are conditioned somehow from the setting?
You ask me for a yes or no?
No, no, no. No, we can discuss.
I choose for myself, not from...
I have difficulties with this either-or questions again and again, because on one hand, every circumstance always makes a difference. And that we're here in this room, and that you're filming, and the people we are together, and everything, it makes somehow a difference. Mm-hmm. But not in the way you asked it, that I think, anyhow for me, it's not that I'm kind of faking because I'm here now in the documenta, blah, 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 and making up a different opinion than if you would ask me somewhere else.
Responses than if you were to talk to them straight, sort of without a camera. That's point A. And point B, by placing your questions in a certain order, by say asking about fundamental beliefs in, I don't know, democracy, solidarity, etc., this gives the question that follow a certain spin. So eventually you might get into a certain mode of thinking. And that's my opinion. It's just an opinion. It's nothing that I can prove or so. It's just.
So in a certain way you feel conditioned by the setting.
If you want to say yes, okay, that involves sort of recapitulating how did I respond to the previous questions, how did I decide so far. At some point, if you go further down that track, it gets more difficult to turn around, right? It's just an opinion.
I'm very interested in your opinion. I would really like to hear what you have to say.
What?
Because you're the only one who's not saying this or that side, that's something between you. I would really like to listen.
Well, fundamentally, I grew up with my feet. I am not from anywhere. I have no ties to a nation state other than a piece of paper. So, the moment that the disadvantages of being somewhere outweigh the advantages, I leave. I have no massive connection to it. I just don't care. If a place decides that they want to go one way and I don't agree, I'm gone.
So you're gone now, actually?
Sorry?
So you're gone now? You're still standing here because you shouldn't leave the room, but you're gone, like in our exile, or did I get you wrong?
No, you got me wrong, but yes. If I don't like something, I vote with my feet, I leave. Yeah. And that is in nation state
politics.
Exactly.
But if you don't like capitalism, where can you go?
Oh, there are plenty of places.
Where?
Up a mountain.
very nice life is earned. No need to own things. You can bend stones together and be happy with that. But the advantages of capitalism still outweigh the disadvantages. And I have a privileged position in it, so good for me. It doesn't work for everyone, but if they don't like it, there are still places they can go that aren't strictly capitalist.
But without other people. So if somebody wants to live without capitalism but with other people,
well, then they have to make a choice. It's whether the advantages outweigh the disadvantages if they want to stay or otherwise. But this is my opinion. If somebody else wishes or thinks different, if they have ties that bind them strongly to somewhere, that's good for them. I can only sympathize with that. It bewilders me, but I can only sympathize with it. I guess it's a good feeling.
So you're happy?
Sure.
And satisfied?
To an extent, sure.
Nothing you would change?
Of course there are things I would change. But, so far, I'm okay where I live. I'm okay with the society I'm in. There are things that irk me, things that piss me off, but until it gets... until that outweighs the benefits that I have of it, then I'm there.
Has directed the sort of discussion towards the topic of Greece. So, is it fair to believe that you are from Greece?
Sorry.
Is it, you sort of steered the discussion towards the topic of Greece. So, is it fair to say you are from Greece?
We are.
Yes. Okay. Is there as much a debate going on in Greece whether the measures which are taken and sort of the things that are put in place or requested of the country are fair, or maybe as the second question, that they are manageable at all? Sort of, that you still see that there is a way out of this? Completely impossible to manage. Just sort of to get an opinion from say the other side.
I think Greece is a failed, it's a bankrupt state. It's going to remain bankrupt as much as it's back a little bit there. We'll never repay back. We'll be in the situation of bankruptcy. So rich Germans can buy their houses for their pensions very cheap. So it's an investment opportunity for you. You should go and buy houses right now. It's very cheap.
So you don't see any chance at all that this could at some point work out?
I'm not an economist, but the people I trust and I read, they think that there's not so big deal. But maybe I'm misinformed, of course. Because it's a matter of belief, somehow.
I agree with you. none that I know of. Probably be cutting the taxes, but at some point the money, as he says, has been lent by somebody, so for sure they have an interest in seeing that money back, coming back. Who's to make the call and to say, hey, okay, this is fair, this isn't?
I would like to ask again the same question, almost the same question that I asked before. So everyone who feels that they are on power to make changes in society, please come to this side.
Any society?
In the society you live in?
Yes.
What changes do you mean?
For example, to influence the situation. To influence the way that society is heading to.
This is
yes, and this is no. And now again, all of those who believe in democracy at this side and those who don't on the other side.
What do you mean? I'm in the middle, but actually I have to stay on this side.
Because you don't?
Because I'm not sure. If I stay on this side, it means I'm sure that I'm not. I like the idea of democracy, but I'm not sure that it works now. So how it works. But I'm an artist as well. I study art and I believe it's my job to influence society. But I have other instruments to do it. So I'm not sure.
To believe that it can be implemented.
So it's not implemented right now, but it should be.
Doesn't necessarily mean that it's not.
Could be implemented like a CD to a computer, or implemented in which way? Implemented is like society is a computer, or you implement the program democracy. What is Germans like to discuss terms?
Okay, so maybe it's a German person who would define it. What is democracy? Give us some earth definition.
Power.
We can keep it. What?
People power. Democracy. That is the. I have understand only with this than you have said. Right? That's why I'm not sure what democracy is meant to define. That is we have always all actually the scene, the feeling for democracy in this because you are the same as me, so they say power as me. I have my vote, my power as Hans and the other just the same. Independent of his place or power or poor and so on. That is an important definition.
Well, I agree with you that it's not so complicated, but there were some people that said it is. And we should define it now, that's why I'm asking.
Yeah, so the question was to improve the democracy. I think all other things can be improved. This is no question.
So I asked if it could be implemented, like put to practice.
Okay, that could be implemented, always.
Mm-hmm.
But not only democracy, all the things.
Fully live it, like to live in a way that your living is beneficial to all beings, which is a Buddhist concept. And it's clear that you cannot somehow fulfill it, but still it's worthy to have it there and to move towards.
You believe it? You agree? That it cannot be fulfilled? But it's good to have it as a guide.
Okay.
I'm saying if you agree with this lady that she said that democracy cannot be fulfilled, but it's worth having it as a guide.
Okay. Okay.
Das ist die beste aller schlechten Lösungen. Wer hat das gesagt? Irgendein Churchill? It's the worst of the good solutions. Maybe you cannot. I did not say that you cannot fulfill it. You made it.
Ah.
I really don't agree with the way that the discussion is running.
Mm-hmm.
Not the contents. That's okay. But this yes or no and having very rough yes or no black and white decisions all the time. Because this is not the way, like to discuss democracy. It's not a democratic way of talking. I mean, there are circle talkings or open space conferences or ways to talk, but here, the acoustic in this room is very difficult. You're somehow difficult to understand. Maybe because of the acoustics and somehow also because of the English, and on both sides, maybe there are difficulties. And then this way of making these decisions between black and white, I really, this for me, this is not a form to talk about. Because it's not a democratic form.
Can you propose a democratic form?
Like spiral talking, you sit in a round and you go around, you have a question and everybody wants to say something, says something, and if he doesn't want to say something, he passes on, and you go again a second and a third time so that you don't have to have fear that you, if you haven't said it in the first round, then it's lost. This is a form of talking which is popular. I mean, there's David Bohm, maybe you've heard about it. For example.
Can we do it now to discuss about the story and see? Can we do that now?
Yes. I don't know.
I think it's right. The first thing we should make is
thank you.
Can you? Maybe if you come closer, it will be easier.
It doesn't. I don't hear well anyway. I don't know if this
yeah.
Doesn't last.
We need some cloth.
Mm-hmm.
Some cloth in the door. Some carpet or cloth. Just any material. And then we go to the
thank you.
and it influences the whole system. So I don't think that we're not just outside or just something. We are really much influenced about the whole system, about capitalism.
Yeah, we're very much inside,
but even the smallest little insight, the way we live or we decide things, still change the whole thing.
But I think the problem is that we are not suffering enough. Like, maybe we don't. We all see the problems of the system. We all know them. We all profit from them. We are all on the winner side, right? So we don't need to change it.
Definitely, but then again, we're the only ones who can actually change them because we're on the winning side.
I need change. You don't need.
No, I mean, I would like them, but I think because she said that we cannot do anything about it. I think we can do something,
yeah,
of course,
can.
And we should.
I understand.
We should, but I think we're just too lazy because
we're
not.
We have something to eat and so on.
Yeah, and
we're not suffering.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe.
I'm suffering if I see somewhere in the world is no justice, for example.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's just impossible that we get something from this situation, that we benefit from it. I would really like to change something, to do something different, but I'm looking for instruments to do it, to build structures. Like, I know of normal people, some people who would like to do something different, but I have to connect them together to do something. You have to put them together in the, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And would you be able to put all your focus? Like,
but I have the feeling if we have to change something, we have to put our focus on that.
I'm not going to change the world.
I'm not so crazy. No, I'm not so crazy. But you know, you can change a lot of things with your decisions.
Mm-hmm.
For example, I don't eat meat. I don't take some medicines and so on. And some people can't earn money. So it's my decision, so I change something.
Consumer radical is what it is.
Right, right.
And this is an Englishman decision. Well,
yes, my decision. And
to change consumer radical.
Yes.
What Greece?
I think that capitalism works the way. If you buy things and then there's a demand and then people produce it, if you would buy it, the demand wouldn't be fulfilled, so there would be no need to.
So that's also accepting capitalism.
That is accepting capitalism, but I cannot change the world right now, but I can still do my little part of it. And as long as I didn't find the perfect solution next door, I can at least do what I can.
Sure, if you want to buy any shit, then it won't be produced. For example. If you say no to something, it can be a no.
I have a question. Who decided that we're talking about democracy and system change? I thought maybe this is about somehow how can we bring something like a collective subject to life.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe this is not the right topic.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Because it's not like a very engaged discussion going on here, and I don't think it's all about the acoustics. I have an opinion to this. I don't think that politics is the best way to connect people, but it's the best way to bring them apart.
Yes, the question is, why are they right in the first place?
No, I don't think they are apart in the first place.
My question was, yes, but why are they apart in the first place? And you said they're not.
No.
But here, there are some people that have said that maybe we want to make some change in the society we're living in, but it's difficult because you have to bring people together in order to do this, and you can't. We have observed a little bit that we are a little bit apart, no?
Depends. So I'm not apart, for example, from my loved ones so much, apart from a stranger I never met before in the streets. But when we all were in this room in the beginning, we were not apart. The question was splitting. And then we got an idea. If you don't mind, I can use an example. You were, when the first, it doesn't depend. If someone is more or less alone on the other, on one side, the masses are on the other side, then the separation begins. My feeling, strong belief is to overcome this very strong opinion thing and just show a little love. Maybe we should all take some dirt and maybe slime and go away. So.
I'm missing from love and we punch up. What should we do?
This is a theoretical question. You were saying, why were we apart in the first run? And I answered that we were not apart in the first run. We were something like a collective subject, because we were all in this room, nobody knows what will happen. And then the separation began, because of asking things, but you have to say black or white, yes or no, this side or that side. And maybe many, or for example, me, as I would take myself as an example, I don't really like to decide for myself, am I black, am I white, am I right, am I wrong, am I warm or cold. I would like to use words that are in between, other metaphors than these contrasts.
Come on, shall I say something for now? Please, Annie, you shall say something for now?
Suggest something for now.
We quit this and here, this is very. For me, the situation feels different since we're sitting in this circle. And we're not jumping from this and that and yes and no. So I think we are quite similar. And if you're interested in connecting people, the way asking the question is not the way to go there.
We should try circles. Circle talk.
Maybe, for example, I don't know if you've done it before. If you're concerned about questions like this kind of an interesting person, or about resonance.
It's how we philosophers actually used to speak to each other.
Yes.
And I just don't see the sense of going to one side or the other. Our opinion changes every day in every situation. It's never black or white.
But I mean, we're not in this situation anymore. We can talk about anything right now. So, and we could also before. I think we could just.
Can you define the reasons why we can do that now and not before?
No, I actually think we could do that before. I never felt that I couldn't say anything before. Yeah.
But can I ask something? If our opinion changes every day,